ready.
Welcome to The Huddle, brought to you by 956sports.com, served by McDonald's on Fox 2. Time to take our weekly tour around the Rio Grande Valley High School football scene in this nocturnal playoff editions. We will start in San Antonio at Hero Stadium, where an Ed Cowchelsea Yellow Jacket team, with all their struggles off the field, wasn't even supposed to make it this far, taking on the 8th-ranked team in the state, the Port Lavaca Calhoun Sand Crabs. And Ed Cowchelsea would start the scoring with Mark Garcia. Running the sweep, Ed Cowchelsea is on the board. The Sand Crabs, Hunter Berm, he would use his own number, call the quarterback keep, and they would tie it up. But the Sand Crabs could not keep up. They fall to Ed Cowchelsea in a 36-34 upset special. The Jackets' next opponent going to be San Antonio Brennan Friday night, Javelina Stadium in Kingsville. Good luck to the Yellow Jackets and all those that will be traveling to support them. Edinburgh North, the Cougars taking on Harlingen South, and Edinburgh North's Matt Whitesides, he would use this great second effort right here off the handoff. Just when you think he's down, boom, ends up in the end zone. Edinburgh North is up 7-0. Now, Harlingen South, known for their offense, also packs quite a defense. Look at this stop. Look at the way they swarmed the runner. It just wasn't enough for the South Hawks, as Eddie Sanchez would catch this pass and eventually run it in, break the plane. They're up 14-0. Harlingen South would drive on their very next possession, and they would only manage a field goal. Too little, too late for the Harlingen South Hawks as they lose 14-3 to Edinburgh North. The Cougars travel to Kingsville to take on Cibolo Steel Saturday night. Brownsville's veteran Memorial Chargers, they would take on the Del Rio Rams, and the Vets coming onto the field. How about this run here from Adrian Alejandro? From inside the 5-yard line, he would put the Vets on the board. But Del Rio's Claudio Arispe, look at this nifty pass right here, as he just finds the open man, and he runs for days. Of course, Marco Munoz, they like to call him Monkey. Watch the way he scrambles around. He is eventually going to get past the defender, up and over into the end zone. Touchdown, Chargers. It just wasn't enough, as Brownsville Vets would fall to Del Rio 35-23. Big game at Bobby Lackey Stadium in Weslaco, where the Sherryland Rattlers would get together with the Harlingen Cardinals, and watch this. Sherryland's Tres Barrera, keep it. He would put the Rattlers up on the board. Now, we saw what they can do on the ground. How about if we show on the air? Tres Barrera to Mario Avila. Nifty little move. He finds the end zone. Touchdown. Now, there's a gentleman by the name of Cesar Valdez who wants to get his name on the books here. Watch this Cesar Valdez run. He breaks the pane, and he is in. More Cesar Valdez. Watch how he is going to escape 3 Harlingen High School Cardinal tacklers right here. Cesar Valdez gets the handoff from Tres Barrera. Here comes hit number 1, 2, and 3. Valdez still on the ground. He is running for days, finds pay dirt. Sherryland would get past Harlingen 42-2. And our man Spencer Gant was on the scene. He'll give us a little analysis. Coach?
Well, I think it just boils down to, they had a great game plan, and they came out and they executed their game plan. And across the board, they had very minimal errors, and they did everything that it took to win a football game. And when you eliminate mistakes and you take care of the football and you execute your game plan, you're going to win.
Thanks, Coach, for that great insight on the Sherryland-Harlingen matchup. Later on in the show, we'll get a different perspective on the Sherryland-Harlingen matchup from the fans' point of view, with 956sports.com very own Oneida Guerra as she takes us onto the field. But Weslaco High was taking on Laredo Alexander, a Laredo Alexander team that features Alexander Skaggs. He gets stopped at the 1-yard line right here, but watch this. The very next play takes the direct snap up and over the line, and that would put Laredo Alexander on the board. However, Weslaco would have their offensive struggles, but Chip Cruz, he would help remedy those troubles. Check this out. 69-yard run right up the gut, gets past the secondary, and Chip Cruz takes it in. Weslaco is on the board. But unfortunately for the Weslaco Panthers, Alexis Skaggs and the Laredo Alexander, they would own the show after that. checked out this run by Alexis Skaggs right here. He takes it, breaks it to the outside. He is running for daylight now. Right up the sidelines, Alexis Skaggs scored 5 touchdowns last week, put up a great number against the Wesico High Panthers. Wesico High season comes to an end at the hands of Laredo Alexander, 57-21. Now, don't forget, if you want to see these highlights and so much more, make sure you visit the website at 956sports.com. And, of course, like us on Facebook, facebook.com/956sports. Your input is always appreciated. And while you're there, make sure you drop in and cast your vote for our fan poll wrapping up this high school football season. And, of course, check out all the playoffs and the upcoming games that we'll have featured next week. We'll come back with more of The Huddle brought to you by McDonald's right here on Fox 2.
Looking for a bit of indulgence? Look no further than the new chocolate chip frappe from McCafe. Every bit as delicious as the McCafe frappes you love, only this one has a bit more, wow, bits of chocolate chips in every sip. Blended into mocha and caramel, all topped with a double drizzle of chocolate and sweet caramel. You've never had a frappe like this. Better get your hands on one quick, because it's only here for a little bit. The simple joy of the perfect sip.
A lot of people don't know who we are, what we do. These girls showed up one day all dressed up, and they thought it was a dance hall. We wanted people to know that we're building materials. Mott's Cash and Carry building materials. People come in and they're surprised. Man, you guys have got great deals. I didn't know you was here. I mean, we've been here for over 40 years. And you thought the good old days were gone forever? We're still here. Mott's Cash and Carry building materials. It's not a dance hall, you know.
Cheerleaders, and you're watching The Huddle on 956 Sports and Fox 2.
Thanks to the Panther cheerleaders for bringing us back from the break. Great job, guys. Great season as well. Time to meet our Wiener Schnitzel Scholar athlete, and Natalie Adeola is going to introduce us to Josh Vela, quarterback of the Edinburgh North Cougars. Natalie?
When it comes to the last minutes of a big football game or the last minutes of an important exam, quarterback for Edinburgh North, Josh Vela's composure and collectiveness is what helps him lead his team to victories and to succeed in his academics.
I'm not very a loud guy, emotional leader, is what, I guess what you would call it. I'm just, I try to keep my cool when the game's on the line and I just come through for my teammates.
Aside from football, Josh's time is spent doing homework and studying for both high school and college level courses.
Well, I want to go into the medical field, go into probably maybe try to get into med school, be a certified like in radiology, and then I'll like deal with sports injuries and stuff like that.
Josh's ambition comes from his mother, somebody he is grateful for.
She it started when she was younger, and she grew up from nothing, a small town about an hour north of here, Falfurrias. She grew up with nothing, and then she became the first person in her family to graduate with a master's degree. And I look to follow her shoes, and I see her try so hard to give us the best, to give me and my sister the best.
Josh hopes his passion and determination will lead his team well beyond the playoffs. For The Huddle in Edinburgh, I'm Natalie Adeola.
Thanks, Natalie. Certainly appreciate your help. Hey, let's get a different perspective on the Sherryland Harlingen game. This time, through the eyes of our very own 956sports.com, Oneida Guerra, as she talks to the students and participants of the game.
There you go.
I'm Oneida Guerra, and tonight I'm at Bobby Lackey Stadium in Wesico, Texas, where the traditional Big Red will be taking on the number one team, the Sherryland Rattlers. We have fans wearing ponchos, the rain's starting to pour hard. Let's see how this will affect our teams tonight.
Yellow diamonds in the light.
Come down on the field with Omar Hunter. Omar, how do you think the rain is going to affect, if it will affect it at all?
I think the rain will factor in a little bit into play. I mean, the ball's going to be a little wet, the field's going to be a little wet, we're running, might slip a little here and there.
We're going to try to do the best we can with this weather.
it shouldn't make a difference in what we plan on doing, and hopefully we come out with a victory.
Kane is in the building.
I'm all fired up for this game, but before that, let's go check out what snacks they have at Bobby Lackey Stadium. So what is the hot seller tonight?
Anything that's hot, basically. Cold drinks aren't really selling well right now, but pizza and nachos and Frito pies.
Hi, who are you supporting here tonight?
Brandon Garza, the quarterback from Harlingen Cardinals.
A quick question. Do you happen to get nervous every time he goes out on the field?
No, actually we don't. We're very calm, positive.
Very relaxed. We try to give him the same energy, so if he sees us calm and relaxed, he's going to be calm and relaxed. And you know what? He's been calm all day, so it makes it easier for us.
Hi, so who are you supporting here tonight?
I'm supporting Sherryland. I'm the father of the quarterback, Tres Barrera.
So let me ask you a quick question. Do you happen to get nervous before his big games?
Well, I've been coaching for about 19 years, and an old coach once told me, "Hey, son, you're not playing the game anymore." So I enjoy the game, and hopefully he can perform.
They have hairspray. Alrighty, well right now I'm with the Diamonds, it's Sherryland Rattler Dancers, and I'm here with Denise. So I see you wearing the sash. Tell me about it.
Well, I'm Diamond of the Week this week. You get Diamond of the Week when you like do a hard work, or you show potential, or you show that you are basically just doing your job.
So I was passing by and I couldn't help but notice the piñata that we have here, the helmet piñata. Why don't you tell us a little bit about this?
All right, well, we're from the Valley Athletic Trainer Association, and she's from Mercedes High School, and I'm from Valley View High School. And what we do is that we're helping Gridiron Heroes with our Fill the Helmet Drive. And what we do is we raise money for spinal cord injury victims, Rio Grande Valley football players that have suffered spinal cord injuries.
Hey guys, so it's almost game time. My photographer is gonna go in there in the locker room to get the inside scoop of tonight's game.
Gentlemen, tonight we've got a great opportunity, fellas, that we've presented or put ourselves in. The perfect opportunity is in our hands. We're 11-0, we're about to play the perennial 5A program in the Valley, men, and it's set up and it's prime. That crown is prime for the taking, men. It's nights like these that you live for as a team. We put ourselves in that situation, men. There's people doubting us. What better opportunity, men, in the second round of the playoffs to show the whole Valley what the Sherryland Rattlers are all about. I want you guys to play hard tonight, men. You've done that all year. We're not ready to put the pads away, men. You play hard for each other. Pull for one another. Hey, there's going to be rain. They're going to have to play in it also, men. It's about adapting and overcoming. And I'm using that as an excuse, boys. Big night tonight, boys. This is what past players, men, live for. They're here. They're with you. You're not going to be alone. The whole Sherryland community is behind you guys. And it's time to make a statement, boys. It's time to make a statement, men. There's a new sheriff in town.
Yes, sir.
And it's time to kick some tail.
Yes, sir.
Everybody understand that?
Yes, sir.